Hi children, this is Venkat Ramana. Today's class, 8th class physical science. Friction chapter. Friction. We are discussing regarding friction. What is the friction? Already we discussed it. The force of opposition. Are the force, opposing force acted by the floor. Are the force of the opposing force acted by one surface, which is with relatively motion with another surface, is known as friction. Now we are discussing about the factors affecting the friction force. Factors affecting the friction, we already discussed regarding roughness of surface. If roughness of surfaces increases, then friction also increases. Roughness of surfaces. Next one is area of contact. If area of contact increases or decreases, this friction won't be affected. That way, what you call two factors we discussed. Factors which will affect the force of friction are, one is roughness of two surfaces, other is area of contact. If the floor or the moving object increases, then what will happen? Force of friction also increases. That means force of friction or frictional force is directly proportional to roughness of surfaces. That's why whenever it is hard to ride the bicycle, if you observe the cranked wheel chain, what do you call it, will be totally rusted. Then we will go for applying the grease or oil to reduce the thickness, to reduce friction, because it will smoothen the surface. Even when you are running on a smooth surface, there is chance of skidding very fastly. Skating we can able to do on what you call smooth surface only, not on what you call rough surface. So if the roughness of surfaces, either the floor or the object which is in motion, or an object which the floor is applying opposing force, in both the surfaces if the roughness increases, then they will be interlocked each other. As a result of interlocking each other, then motion will be restricted, or motion will be, what is it, stopped. Motion will be opposite. That's where frictional force will increase. So, because of roughness of surfaces, what will happen? The frictional force will increase. Now, what about the area of contact? If area of contact either increases or decreases, friction force won't depend. Frictional force is independent of area of contact. Whether it is a large surface area is in contact with the surface, or what you call a smaller area is in contact with surface. Whatever the area is contact in surface, this friction won't depend upon the area of contact. Now third factor is normal force acting on that one. Normal force acting on the object. On this normal force, this friction force will depend or not depend. If it all depends, how it will proportional, that we have to discuss. Now, we will have one table. On the table, then what will happen? We will place one book or one wooden block. Then this is a wooden block. Now try to, what will happen? What do you call push? Try to pull or push, whatever it means. Try to push with the help of a string. Here we have to catch and we have to going and try to pull that one. When you are trying to pull this one, what will happen? Because of friction force, which friction force? Static friction force between this wooden block surface and table surface will oppose the motion of this wooden block. But when you are trying little bit increasing the pulling, then the static friction. What is static friction? The force, opposing force, act between the two surfaces which are relatively in rest position. Here both block and table are relatively resting position. So when you are trying to change the rest state by pulling towards us, then what will happen? Because of static friction, it won't come easily. With a little more force will try to pull, and that static force also little bit increases. But there will be a limit for this static friction. That will call limiting force of static friction. Up to its limiting friction, it won't, what you called, if whatever the applied force is equals to its limiting force of friction, up to that extent of time, it won't move. Now what do you do? What do you have to do? You have to pull with more force. Then whenever we apply more force to overcome the limiting force of static friction between wooden block and table, it starts sliding. It starts sliding or moving. Then when it starts sliding, if you have observed them, what you called readings of spring balance. With the help of a spring balance, we can able to pull now. Now for spring balance, we have to, what you call, tie to a string, and for the spring balance, we'll have a spring inside which will stretch. The length of the stretching of the spring indicates the, what will happen, this our effort or applied force. How much length of the spring will stretch it, that much is the, what you called, our applied force. Now when it starts sliding, when the block starts moving, you note down the spring balance reading. That is a limiting friction of limiting static friction of this wooden block. Okay, now it's going on moving. Now what do you do? Ask your friend, what do you call, keep or some more weight, we place it here on the wooden block, or try to push that wooden block from upwards to the vertically downwards. If you try to, what do you call, apply force vertically or downwards by, what do you call, pushing that one downwards, or add some more weight here. Add some more weight, another block of wooden block you place here. Then its weight will going on apply force vertically downwards. So vertically downwards in which direction? Normal to the surface of this wooden block. That means it is applying a normal force. Who is applying a normal force? This is a wooden block, a second wooden block. Or when you place our palm and what you call, when you are trying to push that wooden block downwards, it is going on applying vertically downward force perpendicular to the surface of the wooden block, which we call it as a normal force. Normal meaning is perpendicular. Now when we add what you call another wooden block, or when you're trying to apply normal force, now you are trying to, what you call, pull this towards us. When you are trying to pull this wooden block towards us, whether we have to apply more effort, or we have to apply more applied force, or what you call a smaller force, lesser force compared to previous cases. Now in this case, we have to apply more force to overcome the limiting force of static friction. Why now the limiting force of static friction increased? Because of application of normal force. Because of application of normal force, or because of the second wooden block, which is going on applying normal force, perpendicular force to this first wooden block. That means it's clear that now you can conclude that when normal force increases, then frictional force also increases. So from these are the main three factors which will affect the frictional force or force of friction. So Frictional force is directly proportional to roughness of surfaces. When the roughness of surfaces increases, then frictional force also increases. Frictional force is independent of area of contact. Whether the large surface base area is there or smaller the base area is there, on that small area of contact, this frictional force won't depend. But the same frictional force is directly proportional to normal force. So we can tell that normal force of friction is directly proportional to roughness of surfaces, and the normal force acting on the object and also but independent of area of contact. In this way, we have factors which will affect the frictional force or force of friction. Now we have to discuss whether this force, frictional force, is necessary or it is enabled. Frictional force is necessary or not? Yes, frictional force is necessary. How we can tell frictional force is necessary? Because of frictional force only, we can able to walk, we can able to run, we can able to ride the bicycle, we can able to ride the bike, we can able to ride the vehicles. Okay, we can able to, what you call, walk, and all these are taking place. That means, is frictional force is necessary? The question will arise. I am going on explaining frictional force to you. Now, if people are going on listening, then in your mind, what you call, a question will arise. If it not arises, you have to habituate of what you call asking questions or thinking in the questionary way. Why is it required? Is it required in your daily life? If it is required in your daily life, where you are using in your daily life? Whether you have used this concept in your daily life, any case, or what you call, you are going to use that concept in your daily life? All that questions, if you going on, ask yourself. Then you will try to get the answers by listening the concepts carefully, by applying these concepts in your daily life. As a result, we can able to get science and technology knowledge clearly. Now, is friction necessary? Question arises. Is friction necessary? Or is frictional force is necessary? Is frictional force is a necessity or an evil? Is friction force, or is friction necessary? First question. Second question is friction evil? Is friction evil? Evil means which is not desirable. Is friction evil? That is the question. Or not desirable. Is it desirable or not desirable? Desirable means we want this frictional, or we don't want friction. Then if we discuss the examples, then we will come to know about, is friction necessary or is friction evil? Now, we cannot walk or run without friction. Because of friction only, what do you call, our surface means wherever we try to walk, wherever we try to run, that surface this friction force automatically comes to play, trying to stop us. Then we can able to stop our walking, we can able to stop our running. As a result, now we can able to actually, we know that when you raise our leg to go for step forward, then what will happen when you raise, suppose these are the legs, when you raise our leg to stop or to step on forward, then because of gravitational force, it will be attracted towards the floor, towards the earth. Then as earth have gravitational force, pulling force, attractive force, we should stick to the earth. Then when that means, if friction force might have been not applied, or if it might have been, it won't come to play, then simply we will be struck to the at one place. We can't able to take out our feet, and we can't able to walk, we can't able to run, even what you called vehicles can't able to run. Okay, all these what you call are possible because of friction. Now what happens if we cannot walk or run without friction? Even let's see the things what will not happen in the world if friction were not present. We will not have any cars and bicycles and scooters, all the vehicles, all of them move only because of friction. Even if somebody, what you call, pushes a car, we will come to, we will not be able to stop because of without friction. According to what you called laws of motion, if any body is in motion, it should continue in the same state of motion until unless a force is applied. But here, when you roll a ball, or when you kick a football, or when a cricket ball is rolling, or if a bicycle is what you call moving, or if a car is moving, or if a scooter is moving, or if a what you call lorry or a bus, any vehicle is in motion, then if you apply brakes, it will comes to rest because of friction force applied by the brakes. If the friction force is not there, then what will happen? Even no vehicle can able to stop once it starts. We cannot walk, we cannot run, and if you push any body, if you push any body, what you call, it will be into totally in motion. It won't comes to rest automatically by itself because of friction force. Friction force comes to play, which opposes the motion of the object, which will relatively motion with other surfaces. Then that's why objects are coming to rest. Or else, what you called, what will happen? This, they will be going on the same motion. Next, it will be not possible to write with the pen because of friction between what you call paper and pen nib. What will happen? That force, friction force will drag the ink and what you call apply on that what you call paper. It will be not possible to write with pen or with pencil if there is no friction. And we will not be able to fix a nail on the wall, or we can't able to construct a building, what you call, if there was no friction. Because of friction force only, because of static friction only, the pillars can able to, what you call, stand firmly, and the building can able to stand firmly because of static friction, which comes to play between the, what you call, construction of the building and what you call floor of the earth. Now all these are what you call tells importance of friction. Is that mean friction is necessary in every case? No. In machinery parts, friction is a evil. Because of friction, machinery parts will be heated quickly. Even what you call, when you ride a car or when you ride a bike for long extent of time, engine will be heated because of friction force comes to play whenever that motor going on runs in the engine. That means it has machinery parts are going to be heated because of friction force. Because of friction force only, sometimes it will be very hard to ride the bicycle because chain will be rusted and the surface will become rough. As a result, we will try to smoothen the surface by applying grease or by applying oil. Even sometimes it will be very hard to close the door knob because of rust formation, means iron oxide formation on that door knob, which is made up of iron. In all these cases, it is not desirable. In that cases, it make our work hard, but most cases, it is necessary. In few cases, it is an evil. It is an evil, or it is not desirable. So from this, we come to know that friction is necessary, and also it is an evil. Now, in next session, we can able to discuss how the friction will produce heat, and how we can able to increase the friction, or how we can able to reduce the friction. Thank you.